Now, who are these strapped and young gods approaching me?
Got a sec?
Oh, hope he doesn't outgrow these. You can admit you just came to see me.
Soon enough, Master Kratos, we can relax, knowing that reality is currently unnibbled. But for now, you must not rest. What else is there?
Something I've been meaning to ask. Once you've projected an emotional trait into spectral form, is it just gone from you? Suppose a friend wished to cast off his melancholy, or a predilection towards pining.
I see, but I'm afraid it's not so simple. My spectral projections give me a measure of emotional breathing room, but it is only temporary. If I fail to reassimilate them, they start to fester.
Fester?
They are concentrated beings of emotion, and if left alone for too long, that emotion feeds on itself and becomes more and more, pronounced. Which is why I must periodically reabsorb them, deal with their emotional baggage internally, and then eject them fully recharged.
Huh. Absorbing all that emotion at once must be pretty bitter medicine to swallow.
Oh, yes, it's quite unpleasant. Terrible, in fact. Do not recommend. Well, best of luck to your friend, good Master Amir. Should I have anything else for you, you'll be the first to know.
Take the hint.
Go away!
Oh, hey. I had a feeling you might pop in here. You know everybody's meeting in Midgard, right? Quality stuff for you.
keep thinking about what you both said. After what happened to Brock. That there's some things we just can't control. I know you were trying to comfort me. But how do we tell ourselves our fate is ours to make? And then when the worst happens, we say there's nothing we could have done. Some people believe life's easier once you accept the fate. Maybe I finally see their point.
Thank you.
I believe that's the last of them.
And that's the last of them. Spectacular work, I guess. Not that I care. You mean nothing to me. Nothing at all.
That's great, friend.
You're not my friend. Goodbye. I love you.
Good gracious.
It's gonna explode!
Hey, the runic word appeared over there.
Sona!
Is drawn to the gravestone.
But Father Fierce, the role for the troublesome.
Well done, Shadow.
Helheim, awaits!
Yeah!
Right side, brother!
I will break you!
Oh!
your step. Better move back.
Once we have defeated these berserkers, what then?
We pay the king a visit and give him more of the same.
We have seen this before. Revenge will not bring you peace.
Is it revenge if justice is served?
That is a question you must answer for yourself.
Good. I was hoping we'd visit the crater again.
We have leftover business to attend to. Bound to be even more dangerous beasties with valuable resources.
Right. Let's go.
I have retrieved your children.
And finally, my little family is complete. Well, any questions before you travel on? I was curious, my dear fellow. You come from lands beyond these, you know?
Yes.
I was wondering, who tended your world tree back home?
My home had no world tree.
No, you had no, but without... How? How did one travel from realm to realm?
On foot or by sea?
Good God, man! No wonder you left! I suppose I needn't take up more of your time. This one has a strong personality. Good thing I've got experience with those. All of the little ones are now safely settled in their new home. You have my gratitude.
Might have done it sooner.
You sought the dragon's offspring. Why?
Ah! To alleviate my heart-rending loneliness, of course.
Oh, that was awfully forthcoming of you.
I normally wouldn't be so candid, but it appears that Anxious Squirrel has learned a thing or two from you about, what was it, not caring about how others perceive you? So I will permit you this one glimpse of my weakness.
To require others is not a weakness.
My goodness, I had not expected such emotional intelligence from one of your... girth.
I do not care.
Oh, well, this was a delightful conversation. Well then, what else, friends?
This will be of use.
Pointier than before. Now go skewer some folk. Let's make some magic! prepare to be very impressed.
Good fit.
Better get that armor nice and bloody. Woo-hoo! Looking good! Now go show it off. Better get that armor nice and bloody. Show it off. Let's make some magic.
We heading out?
This is it, then. The beginning of the end.
The end for Odin. And after that, a new beginning for the rest of us.
Atreus.
I know. I'm just looking forward to seeing all the realms finally standing up to him. Elves and dwarves and hell itself.
You are so certain they will unite.
They have to. After everything they've been through. They have to. Don't they? Anything in Midgard you want to do? You know, while we still can?
Freya and the others are still making preparations for the attack, so there's time. I suppose there's no putting it off any longer. We better get to the Temple Bridge and rendezvous with the others now.
Well, we're back. Ready to call it a night? Our tents are waiting on the Temple Bridge.
Well, brother, are you ready to get some rest? Your tent awaits. Never seen craftsmanship like this before. Can't imagine how old it is. Well enough in Muspelheim.
I mean, probably. Surtur didn't want Samar involved. So instead of them combining to form the Ragnarok beast, he did a workaround that left her out of it.
Well, hopefully he still shows up at Ragnarok to plunge his sword into the heart of Asgard.
And where is that exactly?
Only Surtur knows.
I guess the army of giants fighting at Ragnarok was just part of Groa's lot. There aren't enough giants around. And the ones that are, they're not really fighters, are they?
Yes, giants were never warlike. They were artisans, seers, philosophers, builders, but very few were warriors. Starkadr the Mighty, notably, and of course, Laufey the Just.
Inserter, right? All those stories about honing his sword and training for Ragnarok? But it was literally the last thing he wanted.
A nice knife. Shame it's rusted. Well, that's all the lost artifacts from Tyr's temple. Fancy a visit to a certain dwarven shopkeeper?
Thinking, how would Groa tell Odin that an army of giants would defeat him at Ragnarok? Because he believed that prophecy, he spent his life killing the giants off. That can't be what Groa wanted.
It's complicated with giants, especially powerful seers like Groa. If she foresaw their deaths, she wouldn't have viewed them as preventable. Perhaps in supplying the justification, she honored their sacrifice and put it to use, enabling the true prophecy of their eventual survival.
What can I do you for? This is from one of them other lands, huh?
realm tear made by Garm. We're gonna close it, right? One more realm tear over there.
Behind you, brother!
That's all! Behind you, incoming! Almost got it!
All of Garm's handiwork has been fixed.
Good. I am glad.
Well, how about that?
I'm glad too. Feels good to fix my mistakes. Should we tell Rostfugger?
Perhaps.
She knew the tears were closed. And there's no reward for closing them, I'm afraid.
We expected none.
Well, then I wouldn't advise staying. She is a corpse eater, after all.
Okay. Yeah. And let's go.
Ding dong, hello. Anyhow, was there something else you wish to talk about? The little ones are growing up so fast, it brings a tear to my eye.
How are they coming along?
I think they're almost starting to recognize me as their father and not their appetizer. I believe one or two of them may even know how to say my name. Or rather, scream it. More of a... But it's not far off.
Must be tough being a parent.
It has its ups and downs, but after a few ages pass, I'm certain they'll start to take a liking to me. There's no rush. Baby dragon steps. Master Kratos knows what I'm speaking of.
No.
He knows what I'm speaking of. I think that's the long and short of it. Safe travels.
Do you not understand that the conversation is over?
Huh?
he'd left something behind.
Oh, it's real good for wood. Better for bone.
That relic, do you suppose it's the one we read about? Something to counteract a sleeping curse? Thank you.
I got more stove. Ready to forge.
Look, another one of those things.
They want to stop the wisps, brother.
Certainly did the trick. I somewhat missed fighting trolls. Didn't you? Don't forget to grab what they dropped. I bet Lunda can make some armor out of it.
Okay, ready when you are. All the armies are probably gathered in their home realms, waiting for when we blow Gjallarhorn. I guess I was kind of hoping to see some of them here.
When all the realm towers open at once, we'll see plenty, lad. Odin won't believe what's coming for him.
No. Odin had lifetimes to prepare for this. Whatever Groa's deception, he heard the truth as Tyr. Do not underestimate him.
Rousing speech, brother. Very inspirational.
Wow. The Valkyries look different.
Welcome back. Hilda Sfini informed me of your success. We've been planning accordingly.
Well, what would Ragnarok be without Ragnarok?
Who else agreed to join us? I see the Valkyries.
Better than that. They are reborn. Corporeal and uncorrupted, thanks to no small amount of Vanir magic. They're shield maidens now.
Nice.
And your brother?
He came through. The elves called a truce to unite against Asgard. That gives us an advantage by air, and with Hel's army for a vanguard.
What about Sindri? Will the dwarves fight?
We haven't heard from him, but there's time yet. And I think we have what we need to clear a path for the Ragnarok beast.
Well, when you say it like that, why worry at all? It's good to see you so alive.
Oh, yes. I wasn't myself when last we met. I'm glad you're safe. My queen, the Shield Maidens will be divided among the forces breaching from Alfheim, Helheim, and here in Midgard. We stand ready. Kratos, Atreus, Mimir, please excuse me.
Oh. Good night, then.
Freya, have you determined our path out of Asgard?
If the towers are the way in, we count on them being the way out.
And if they are not?
Then we all know what we signed up for. Our plan is only missing one thing. A leader.
That honor is yours. You have a righteous claim. And the respect of your troops. And you have faced this enemy before.
I held his invading army to a stalemate. This is our invasion, a siege on his terrain. I want our most experienced wartime general in the field. I don't care about the honors, I don't care about the prophecies and champions. I just need us to win.
Freya.
I know what I'm asking. Just sleep on it. Here we are. Kratos, your tent is to the right, and Atreus, yours is to the left.
Mine?
A young warrior needs his own space, don't you think?
I do. Wow. Thanks.
Sleep on what we spoke of. Let me know in the morning what you decide.
Hildi. Join us. Have a seat.
I miss anything?
I was just telling them about the time I asked you to play damsel in distress. Okay, then...
then, when she had them distracted, I jumped in heroically. And together, we took them all down. There must have been 100.
I don't know, maybe more.
Spare us your gloating.
Does it really bother you that some of my ideas actually work?
No, but I do envy you.
In what realm? Spare me the patronizing.
I've calculated every risk I've ever taken, tried to mitigate all the ways it could go wrong, and still, it all falls apart. You just throw yourself into situations in harm's way, and somehow it always works out for you. You always end up all right with that stupid grin.
I'd argue, my trip to Asgard didn't go quite so well.
Yes, there are some lessons to be learned by planning. And others by learning to adapt. That's why you two were such a great team.
I'd argue it's because we had such a lousy old man.
Son, it's true Njord was not much of a father. But he's the reason we were able to be a family.
Yeah, funny you should be so hard on him, Freyr, since you inherited his wanderlust. Especially in times of importance.
That's not true. I had good reason for leaving those times. Tell her.
I have missed this.
Are you nervous, love? I'm nervous. What if they don't accept us? What if they don't follow us into battle? I mean, in their eyes, we're an abomination.
And how is that our problem and not theirs? Uniter has spoken. That should be enough. They will follow.
And if it's not enough?
Then I will make them.
That sounds like the elf I fell in love with.
You're shivering.
I'm cold.
We can leave for Alfheim now, if you want.
No. No, I'd like to stay here for as long as we can.
Hey, is it okay if I just hang out here for now? Nothing's wrong. I just want to be alone and think.
I bring stone.
Ooh, yeah, I can sure make something out of that. Where'd you get it?
Trolls.
Oh, trolls! Look at you!
Excuse me. May I have a moment with Mimir? I don't know what tomorrow brings, but if tonight is our last night, I'd like to spend it feeling something besides hate. Will you tell me one last silly story?
There's nothing I'd like more. Except perhaps a dance. Though I may have lost a step. Due respect, love. I don't tell silly stories.
You only tell silly stories,
I can never argue with you.
Can I sleep here tonight?
Story.
If I fall asleep, promise you'll finish it tomorrow?
Of course. Now, close your eyes. Was an old man who chopped wood for his village. Every evening he bore the logs on his back and delivered them to his people. But the logs were heavy, and he grew weaker as time went. And one day he threw down the logs, as he could no longer bear their weight. And he called for death to come to him. And when death arrived,
the only one who ever got my highbrow sense of humor. Damn fine woman she was. Apart from her taste in men, of course.
She was a special woman. She wanted to protect people.
She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us, watching over us, leading us home.
Has my request upset you? Death is a natural part of life, my love. I wish only to be prepared for when my time comes. Mortals must do such things. I am glad to have you prepare with me. You are quiet.
I have nothing to say.
Well, say something. I enjoy hearing your voice.
A funeral pyre. I would have chosen different.
Oh? You would have me trapped in the ground for eternity.
I would have you close to me.
How touching. My rotting corpse would bring you such comfort. You once tried to take charge of your ending, did you not?
That was different.
Circumstance, yes. But not on purpose.
You prepare for a distant future. There is much time ahead of us.
I wish to better a future that will exist without me, whenever that day comes. For you, and for our son. We will always walk together, Kratos. You will always be a part of me. I will always be a part of you.
And when you are gone, that part of me dies as well. Faye, to feel your absence.
No. Culmination of love is grief. And yet we love, despite the inevitable. We open our hearts to it. When the pyre is spent, and you have gathered my ashes, spread them from the highest peak in all the realms. You will do this for me. Is to have loved fully. Open your heart to the world as you have opened it to me, and you will find every reason to keep living in it.
What's going on?
It is time.
I'll meet you outside, Father. Sir.
hope to fly into battle with you one more time, my queen.
Me too. But not as your queen. As sisters. Are you ready?
Yes. I will be your general.
It will be an honor to fight alongside you, General.
Aye, brother. I'll be right by your side. So, what are your orders?
To the temple.
Storm in Asgard and whatnot. I thought you could make use of it.
Indeed. Fits.
Woohoo! Looking good! Now go show it off. Better get that armor nice and bloody. Big softy, you can thank me after, if we all come through the other end.
I will.
Woohoo! Looking good!
It fits.
Now go show it all.
Fits.
Woohoo! Looking good! Now go show it off.
Good luck out there, General. I believe in you.
General.
Sir?
General?
General?
Sir.
Hey, bud. General.
came to these lands. To escape my past. To start a new life. I can hide no longer. I do not want this war. We have suffered enough. Prophecy did not lead us here, nor will it win this battle. Wars are won by those that are willing to sacrifice everything. If that is the cost of vengeance, so be it.
Odin has taken so much from us already. The realms have suffered enough. No matter the cost. This ends today.
If going out in a blaze of glory means that Odin burns too, might as well be. A big fat smile on my face.
Brock.
Tower's fallen.
If Odin goes after Niflheim next...
They're trying to shut out Ragnarok.
We gotta stop those war machines.
Not an ideal start.
Got work to do.
You three, follow. Atreus. Freya, with me. Watch our flanks. To the war machines.
Thank you.
Watch Tower's not looking so good.
There's still time. We have to go.
Anger Bodo, I knew you'd show up.
What's our next plan, brother?
We have no other plan. Our focus remains on the war machines.
We should head for the flaw behind the Asgard towers. Without Ragnarok, it's our only chance to break through the wall.
Princess flaw! You said only sometimes you had to use it.
Let's say I was wrong.
Watch your head!
Keep an eye on that tail!
The war machines! We use them to breach the flaw and strike the city with our allies.
Sounds desperate.
Good. Desperation is our advantage.
Would have preferred a realm-destroying fire giant, but I suppose desperation is better than nothing.
Odin's new Valkyrie queen is Gnom.
I would think so.
Then we must hurry.
Here it comes! Thank you!
moving!
At least that army is already dead.
We're getting nowhere! The Einherjar returned from Valhalla as quickly as we kill them!
There goes the Alpine reinforcements!
We are running out of armies.
Looks like the giants made it after all.
The snake looks different.
He is different. But when I was away, never mind, later.
The Einherjar's link to Valhalla. My sisters and I must sever it.
Go.
Still no sign of the dwarves.
Sindri won't let us down. We have to trust him.
Rally all you can. We will make for this funnel hunt tower.
So what's the plan? How are we gonna breach the wall without Ragnarok?
The war machines.
Oh, so we're pretty desperate, huh?
Stop him!
Careful, brother. You're covered in Vicron.
Back side, brother!
Bucky Lee! Dragon, incoming!
Watch for the horn!
Damn, Dragon, what's the deal? Why isn't he here?
Your friend.
She'll be fine. We got more important things to worry about. Even if we can breach the wall.
Perhaps it is better this way.
Better for who?
I'm late.
Where is your army?
No more dwarves are dying for this. Save it! Odin forced them to build these war machines. And I'm here to tear them down.
Before you break them, we must turn them on the floor.
Fine. Leave it to the dwarves to clean up after the giants.
That's what you wanted.
I didn't want this. No,
Close your heart to it. Close your heart.
Who are they?
Midgardians. Odin took them in. They shouldn't be here. They're not soldiers.
Odin put them in our path to die.
It's war. Wars are won by those who are willing to sacrifice everything. What are you doing?
Son, listen closely. You feel their pain because that is who you are. And you must never sacrifice that. Never. Not for anyone. I was wrong, Atreus. I was wrong. Open your heart. Open your heart to their suffering. That is your mother's wish. And mine as well. Today, son. Today, we will be better.
But what can we do?
See the size of that thing? Well, I think we're gonna win. I mean, if they don't kill us first.
Why have you stopped? Ragnarok is here. We finally have Odin right where we...
We will stop Odin. But we did not come to sacrifice the innocent. We will breach the wall at Hrimthor's flaw.
With what army?
Atreus and I will be enough.
That's suicide.
It may be. But we will die seeking justice, not vengeance. Can that weapon break open the flaw?
Only one way to find out.
You three. Get those people to safety wherever you can find it.
We will see it done.
Freya and I will do what we can to slow Ragnarok.
He was not mindless before. See if he will listen to reason. Odin will not get away.
If he does, so help me.
I know.
Falky!
No! No! Protect him! I will help those that are trapped, and meet you at the wall. Go! Go, Atreus!
Sentry, be careful and stay behind me!
You be careful. I'm here to fight.
Stop him! Can I just say?
No, you can't. Shut up and fight.
Yeah!
Tiapa!
Care what you want.
This changes nothing.
You really had me believing you that we didn't have to be enemies.
Dude, you're okay.
My mom was right about you all along. You're a killer just like your father, and you're here to kill us all.
No, just Odin.
Sindri, don't!
She's a friend.
Friends don't bring the end of the world to each other's doorstep, Loki!
You're right. You're right. I made some bad decisions.
You do that a lot. I'm not sure that's a defense.
It's not a defense. I just want to make it right. Is Skjöldr okay? Have you seen him?
Why wouldn't he be? What are you talking about?
Odin is willing to sacrifice the Midgardians. He put them along the wall to try and deter us, knowing they can't fight. Their deaths are just meant to slow us down.
Why would he do that? And how am I supposed to believe you?
Because he's right. It's who Odin is. It's who he's always been.
Mom, why are you here? What?
He'll sacrifice anyone at a problem in front of him. The Midgardians. Your friend. Our family, any of us. I had hoped that your father would stand up to him, but now it has to be you.
Mom, what are you saying?
Thrud. I never doubted that you would make the finest Valkyrie these realms have ever seen. But not for him. Do you understand?
But our family.
Without Odin, we can be one again. A real one. What he's doing is wrong.
He said if we held our ground, we'd be safe. And he said we owed him.
You don't owe him your death.
No shit.
Dad will never let them get their grandfather.
Then go with him. He'll listen to you. Are you ready to go find the rest of your people?
Yeah.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
finally.
Great Lodge. It's where we gotta go.
Yeah. Is it Monolith?
That may not be our biggest problem right now.
Storm Engager!
Get back to your sister. You must hold back Ragnarok. This fight is mine.
But if I could just...
Take Atreus and the mask and do not look back. My son trusts you, so I trust you.
Get away from her!
Dad, wait!
I am done with you and your son! No more fucking games! And this time, I'm allowed to kill you. We do not need to do this! We do! It's what we are! Won't be enough!
Thor! The lad seems to think you've changed! Prove it and stop it!
Talking's over! Wait and die! Is that it? I can take... Can you...
You're what the old father made you! You can choose to-
You are!
Come on!
This is your time. First, then your king.
Try to hurt her.
I would not.
Don't you know what I've done?
Yes!
But what will you do now? We don't change. We destroy us.
No more. No more. For the sake of our children, we must be better.
Why isn't he dead?
Are you talking? Who told you to do that? You don't talk! You don't think! I think you kill! It's a simple fucking concept!
Sif was right about you. I just didn't want to see it.
What is this? Are you broken? I am your father. Take the hammer and kill who I tell you to kill!
I didn't want this. I did not want this.
No!
Rude. This was all their fault. They've done this to us, to our family. Looks like I gotta do everything around here.
You wrote, son! You planned on!
Rude's gonna be fine. I say, and Thor. That one's on you. You turned him against me. You turned them all against me. Let go!
On your right! Please! Stop this!
Stop this! Just give me my map!
Sure! Trust you! Sounds like a great idea!
Come to my land! Turn my family against me!
You started this fight!
No, no, no! This all started long before you showed up. You are a nobody. A plain, God killer! This is what you wanted, right? No more!
Is everything you hoped for? Was your plan really all that much better than mine? I hope you got exactly what you want.
Not quite yet. Think you're the only one who can craft a binding spell? I spent many long winters thinking about what I would say to you as I watched you take your last breath. But now, I realize there's only one thing I need you to know. You have no hold on me anymore!
And that's my friend. I forgot how good you look with wings.
Oh, husband. You always sought knowledge well. Now I'm going to teach you what it's like to lose everything. Bow to your queen!
I always loved you. You know.
You've never loved anyone!
We don't talk about it.
Father?
Freya?
You did it, Loki. No, no, no. No more fighting. No. None of that matters now. This is your moment, Loki. Groa tried to hide you from me, but this is your destiny. Champion of the Jotnar. Only he can put on the mask. Only he can gaze into the truth of creation. Unfold the secrets of life and death. No more doubt, no more confusion. You were born for this. Put on the mask, Loki. Ask it the question.
This is your choice, son. I trust you.
Choose to be nothing! No! So be it.
Attack!
You've waited a long time for this, haven't you, Frigg? So have I!
Too late for that!
Fly!
Fuck me!
Don't forget me, old fucker! What did you call me?
That one's for Brock!
You and your little vines!
Use your arrows!
I got it!
Left side! Incoming!
You don't get it!
No!
No! No! You've ruined everything! Everything I worked for! Everything I killed for! I just bought this after!
Use your arrow.
If you just played your part, none of this would have happened.
What was it all for?
Answer me, Loki. What's it all for?
Right.
was our chance, Loki. I could have had my answers. I could have learned the truth. You took that away from me. I could have made things better. We could have made the Nine Realms better.
This was never about the realms or me. It was about you.
You destroyed everything. My home, my family, my kingdom.
You did those things. Your choices. You killed your own son.
It wasn't my choice. I had no choice.
There's always a choice.
You have to stop. You can choose to be better.
No, I can't. I have to know what happens next. I will never stop.
Why'd you have to say that? Sofna. Apfra. Tesu. Sofna. Hithan. Sofna. Sofna.
I swore I would never rob from you the choice between life and death.
I have waited so long for this moment. And now that I'm here, I don't need this to make me whole.
We stopped his madness. That's all that matters.
That's what comes next.
Ragnarok. He's here. Time to go. Go where exactly?
You didn't exit?
How will it be?
It's giant stuff. Okay, follow me. Quickly.
Time.
Right where you're supposed to be.
Huh?
There he is. Wake up, Atreus. Wake up. Glad you've come back to us.
Hi. Where is my father?
Somewhere here in the Holt. He'll be glad to see you.
Thanks, Herr. I should find my father.
Mom, stop it. I'm fine.
Hush. I won't have rot set into this home.
Loki!
I'm so glad you're both alive. You have no idea, and I'm sorry. Thor. He tried, you know? I'm sorry I couldn't do more. Nothing will fix what you're feeling. But I hope there's some comfort in knowing Odin's gone.
There absolutely is.
Loki. It was an honor to fight alongside a giant. Know that.
Will you stay here in Midgard?
For a bit? Then I've got something I need to find.
I'm working with Hildisvini to get the rest of the Asgardians to Vanaheim. To help rebuild.
Then I hope it can be a fresh start for them. And you. Oh, and Thrud. I hope you find what you're looking for. Good luck.
See ya, Loki.
Take care. Were either of your weapons damaged in the battle?
I think they're fine. Maybe a couple nicks here and there.
Well, we can have them looked at later.
We might not need to.
Nonsense. A shield maiden needs all her tools in working order. That Sigrun would probably chew you out if they were dull.
Oh, she would she?
I know I certainly would.
I also know you would.
Lugan made it out. Good for him.
Oh, and if you could get this wood over to Brana's tent, she'd really appreciate it.
Skildr?
Loki! Hey! Glad to see the head injury didn't make you forget me. Did you have a head injury? Everything was a blur. Maybe that was someone else. Anyway, man, I'm really glad to see you.
I'm glad to see you too. Looks like you're keeping busy.
I'm just happy to help folks. We're on track to have bedrolls for everyone, and your friend's wolves have been helping out with hunting. We should have plenty to feed everyone.
No shit.
No shit? And hey, thank you for everything. We wouldn't even be here without you and your friends.
Yeah, of course. I just wish we could have gotten more people out.
Loki, you did good.
Thanks, Skildr. Take care, okay?
Hey, you know me. Has anyone seen any extra blankets lying around? That snow might be melting, but it's still gonna be pretty cold in this place. Better load up on extra tinder in case the fires go out. What else?
Oh, there he is. And one for the kid, too. Skull!
Here, here.
Skull, we wouldn't be here if it weren't for you. And Freyr's sacrifice.
It's true.
Well, we were just swapping our own Freyr fables.
Right, right. So where was I? Oh. When we met, I was expecting this warrior, this master planner, a born leader. The legend came before the man. But the man himself was very different. He won me over, though. He was just so damn kind.
I think it helped that he was handsome.
This is true. And incredibly charming.
All right, stop. Y'all are about to start crying all over again.
Sorry. Gotta go find my father.
Be safe, you! Y'all remember that time old Ski Bluff near caught on fire?
If I remember correctly, it was you who lit it on fire in the first place.
Well, not on purpose. How was I supposed to know it was so easily flammable?
It wasn't. You were showing off that enchanted bellows of yours and sparks flew everywhere.
Ha ha, that is what happened, isn't it? Oh, boss man. Oh my.
I'm pleased to see you awake.
Freya.
It was his choice. I couldn't take that from him.
He saved us all. I'll never forget that.
The family I thought I had was taken from me piece by piece. But there's comfort in the family I've chosen. Your mother was right, you know. You grew into that bow after all. You are a formidable warrior, but even more than that, you have a good heart. Nothing you've endured has changed that. I'm so proud of the man you've become, Atreus.
Thank you. For everything. I should find my father.
You should.
Atreus! Oh, you gave us quite a scare there.
Glad to see you too, Mimir. Listen, I want to thank you.
Oh, what else did you expect from the smartest man alive?
It's not just because you're smart. You listened to me, mentored me, and, well, you're basically another dad to me.
What?
No, I need you to hear it. I appreciate you so much.
Huh. I love you too, little brother.
See you, Mimir.
It's good to see you about, Atreus.
You too, Hildisvini.
I'd see the day Vanir and Aesir existed in peace.
How optimistically presumptuous of you.
I suppose so.
We offered to take them in, but I don't expect things to be easy right away.
Well, something to work towards.
Civility is certainly a start.
And it's nice down here, huh? No loud noises. We're okay. You did so good today, boy. I'm so proud of you. Maybe later, we can find some treats.
Okay. My turn.
Who's that, huh? Yeah, we know him.
Maybe one of these days I'll surprise you.
Oh? You already have.
You are in good hands.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for saving us.
I decided it would be better if I wrote the ending myself. You haven't told your father yet, have you?
Told him about what?
Come on. Giant visions? I already saw it. I get it.
Every part of me is telling me this is what I have to do. I just don't know how to say it.
Come with me. I've got something I want to show you. Both of you.
I do not wish to intrude.
This is for you too.
You are well.
I'm glad you are too. So, what was the end of the story?
What?
Before Ragnarok. You promised to finish it if I fell asleep.
When Death arrived, he asked why the old man had called for him. Seeing Death before him caused the old man to reconsider his request. After a moment, he asked that Death help him lift the logs onto his back so that he may continue on his journey.
He wasn't ready to die.
He wished to keep living.
There's a lot of smoke out there.
It seems when Asgard fell, pieces of it landed all over the realms. There might still be some Einherjar near them, but that's not what I brought you here to see.
Mother? My shrine in Jotunheim. She destroyed it. She didn't want us to know our fate.
We forged our own path because of her.
She went against her own people. Our people. To protect you. It don't all open. I'm sorry.
Father, I need to talk to you about something. There are other giants out there, and I've got to find them. I think I know where to look, but they're
my responsibility. I need to do this alone. I don't want to do it alone, but I need to. It's hard to explain.
Does it frighten you?
Yeah.
That is why you must do it.
Like you taught me. Yeah.
We survived today because of your choices. Who to trust? Who to call friend? Son, you are ready.
Remember our promise.
One I had never imagined.
now?
There is much to do. Much to rebuild.
We should probably talk about Gnar.
We don't need to talk about her. We just need to find her.
But Odin chose her as his new Valkyrie queen. A Vanir goddess. Your friend.
Gnar pledged loyalty to Asgard long ago, and our friendship ended soon after.
What happened?
I made a choice. One she couldn't accept. Kratos. She hates me. She will be a problem for us. Better we find her than she finds us.
And another one for the big boy himself. Skull!
Skull!
Hold a few dozen per cap. Families will stay together, obviously.
Take care, Kratos.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And we'll bring all the supplies we can, although it won't be much.
Don't worry about it. Anyone who's able can head out for extra supplies. Aesir and Vanir.
Together.
General, Lady Freya, Mimir.
My lady.
Shield maidens.
Blessed Thor, have you found the traitor Gnar yet, dear Freya?
Not yet.
Soon.
One final word. We wish to offer condolences.
What for?
For your family. Your brother.
We didn't mean to pry, sister.
Mm-hmm. It was a lifetime ago. Memories in ruins. I'm surprised there was anything left.
I just wish you'd told me. I would have understood.
What's done is done, dear Mimir. I appreciate your kind words.
Where to first?
We could take care of any lingering business in the realms.
Or investigate those pieces of Asgard.
Either way, we're with you, brother. Lunda also mentioned there's going to be a get-together to honor Brock's memory at Rab's Tavern in Svartalfheim. I'd like to go.